لله الذي أحسن كل شيء خلقه وبدأ خلق الإنسان من طين، وأصلي وأسلم على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله تعالى، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. I bear witness that there is none worthy of our worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the seal of the prophets and the final messenger to all of humanity. Whoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides, there is none to misguide. And whoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala leads to stray, there is no one to guide to the right way. Today's khutbah, as usual inshallah, I'm going to begin with a short story. And I always say that a good story to a khutbah or a speech is like spices to biryani. It gives it ruh. So this is a story that happened with me in the US many, many years ago. It was Ramadan time. We're having iftar in the US. And there was this new Muslim brother. We're having iftar together at the masjid. And I'm always interested in people's Islam story, how they came to Islam. And this brother, he said that he came to Islam through an amazing, amazing Muslim drug dealer. And I said, dude, how is this possible? He said he used to buy drugs from different people, but this Muslim guy, he was very honest. You know, if you buy 10 grams, it is 10 grams. But the other guys, they're playing games with him. And he said, I'm not the only one who accepted Islam through this Muslim drug dealer. So many people. And subhanAllah, I always say, if this guy, the Muslim drug dealer, was not actually practicing Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided so many people through him, imagine if you do da'wah the right way. You have the training to do da'wah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will guide so many people through you. So now, in the past, I've been doing da'wah for the last 16, 17 years in the US and Canada. And subhanAllah, I didn't have the training because not everyone is trained to do da'wah. Because da'wah is an art. You know, when, let's say if someone needs medical attention, so you walk down the road or you go to downtown and you see a guy sitting somewhere on the floor with a sign that says, I'm a doctor. So what is the proof, what is the dalil that you're a doctor? Because I have this handwritten sign that says I'm a doctor. I can operate on you for 25 bucks. Who is going to go to this guy? No one. And therefore, if you cannot trust your body to someone who's not qualified, how can you trust your ruh, your soul, to someone who has no knowledge? In da'wah, in Islam in general. We have a beautiful saying in Urdu. I love biryani so much, and this is why me achieve Urdu Boltam. You know, we say Neem Hakim Khatra Jan, Neem Mulla Khatra Iman, right? Half a doctor is dangerous to your life, and half a scholar is dangerous to your iman. So always look for the best. So now, when you do da'wah, you cannot just say whatever you want about Islam. It's an art. You have to be trained to do da'wah. So in the past, many years ago, when I started doing da'wah, let's say if we go downtown to Young and Dundas in Toronto, or you go somewhere else, and you have a sign that says, you know, learn about Islam or ask questions, and we have da'wah materials on the table, some missionaries will come and they will challenge. You know, they ask questions about Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, about the Quran, about Allah, and mashallah, you get excited because you used to watch too much Ahmad Didat and, you know, if they challenge you, I'm going to challenge you and your whole family. Let's go fight. You know, subhanAllah. If they ask you a question about women in Islam, if they ask you a question about, oh, why do you wash your feet in the sink? You go after those questions. Each question will take you 1 hour, half hour. You keep going on. Why you guys don't eat pork? You go on for half hour. Alcohol, another half hour. Hijab, half hour. And the person who is asking the questions, they are never satisfied. And they keep jumping from one question to another. So they ask hijab, pork, this, that, biryani, kushari, shawarma. And you are going after the questions. And subhanAllah, they are never satisfied. And imagine if you take a whole week answering all of these questions. And this person dies
Do you think they are going to Jannah? The answer is no, because you didn't tell them anything about Islam. You're just answering questions. And sometimes the ego comes in, I want to show them that I can win debates, I can answer questions. But what you need to do really is to focus on the big picture of Islam, not just a small pixel. This is what most of us do when we do da'wah. You go to London, the speaker's corner, they're debating, shouting at each other, calling each other, himar, this, donkey. No. Rasulullah ﷺ did da'wah with hikmah al-maw'idhat al-hasana.
Now, I work with this organization, it's called AYIRA, Islamic Education and Research Academy, which is based in the UK. And they started 2010-2011, and alhamdulillah we have an office now in Mississauga, and we've been very active in da'wah. We train people on how to do da'wah. So when you look at the Quran, how did we get this style or this technique of da'wah from? From the Quran and from Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, right? So when you read in the Quran, there are 25 prophets who are mentioned in the Quran. Can you show me from the Quran how Musa alayhi salam prayed? How Isa alayhi salam fasted? How did they do Hajj? You will not find these details. What is the focus in the Quran? How they did da'wah. That's it. Every prophet came to their own people. They invited them to believe in Allah. They invited them to Tawheed, Yawm al-Qiyam. So there is a focus. So this style or technique that we use at AYIRA is called GORAP. The G stands for God's existence. The O stands for oneness, that Allah is one. And the R stands for revelations, like Quran, and prophethood. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a prophet from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, when you look, for example, just one example to illustrate. When you look at the Quran, how Musa alayhi salam did da'wah to Fir'aun, this is very clear in Surah Shu'ara 26 and Surah Taha. So, Musa alayhi salam comes to Fir'aun, and he invited him to believe in Allah, Tawheed, and this and that. How did Fir'aun respond? He said, Ana Rabbukum al-A'la, I'm your Lord, the Most High. Then Musa alayhi salam said, no, Allah created everything, you didn't create anything. Then he goes on to say that Musa alayhi salam is crazy. But Musa alayhi salam was on point, he is focused. Rabbukum wa Rabbu abaykum. No, Allah created you, is your Lord, and the Lord of everyone who came before and everyone who is coming after. Then Fir'aun said, what about مَا بَالُ الْقُرُونِ الْأُولَى? What about the people who died 1,000 years ago? Musa alayhi salam continues talking about Tawheed, Allah's existence, He is one, He is worthy of your worship. Then Fir'aun said, لَإِنِ اتَّخَذْتَ إِلَٰهًا غَيْرِي لَأَجْعَلَنَّكَ مِنَ الْمَسْجُولِينَ. I'm going to throw you in jail or I'm going to kill you. Then Musa alayhi salam is focused on Tawheed. So this is why when you do da'wah and people try to distract you by talking about politics and this and that. No, focus on tawheed, the five things that we mentioned here. And you'll find this in the stories of our anbiya, they are always focused on tawheed. That's it. So now, the gora, God's existence, oneness, prophethood of Muhammad ﷺ, and the revelation of the Quran, this should be the focus. If they ask you about anything, any of those questions that I mentioned, jihad, women, this, that, tell them, I need to give you an overview, the big picture, not just a small pixel. I need to give you the whole picture. The whole picture is, we are here in this dunya for a reason, to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He created us. And maybe you are going to use a short story to illustrate, because people love stories. So I remember, 2008, we were in the UK, London, doing street da'wah. So there was this street clown. His name was Aaron. So we were there for like 2-3 hours. We're handing out da'wah materials, teaching people about Islam. People were not interested. Just like here, subhanAllah, in Toronto downtown, people, they don't smile. They're just about business. They don't want to talk. That's it. So I asked him, you know, Aaron, do you have a couple of minutes? He said, yes. I said, okay. Imagine you open your eyes one day, you found yourself on an airplane, but you don't remember ever going to the airport. You never went to the Pearson airport. So you start to ask yourself some questions. Who put you on this plane? Where is this plane going? And you ask yourself, why am I on this plane? So who put you there? Why? And where is this plane going? These are some logical questions. And now you ask the people around you on the plane, who put us here? What are we doing here? Where is this plane going? The destination? Nobody seems to know or care. And I told him, if you read Surah Fatiha of the Quran, you will find the answers to these three questions. So this plane is planet Earth. You open your eyes, you found yourself here. Right? Who put you here? رب العالمين, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What are you doing here? إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين. Where is the destination to stand before? مالك يوم الدين, to judge you. It's very simple, right? So when I told him this story 2 minutes, subhanAllah, he took shahada. I didn't have to tell him any philosophical arguments and Einstein. No, very simple. Because people's fitrah is clouded, and when you use a story or something simple like this, subhanAllah, they come back to their senses. So when you do da'wah, inshallah, focus on 4 things, and we can provide free training. If you'd like to join Ayura, go to ayura.org or ayura.ca, and you will receive the free training. So you can do da'wah, inshallah, with a focus on God's existence, oneness, He is one. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a prophet, the Quran is from Allah, and you can easily establish these facts without having to fight with anyone. With hikmah wa ma'idatul hasanah. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the best in this life and the best in the life to come. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. الحمد لله رب العالمين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أرسله ربه رحمة للعالمين. Just a quick reminder in the last couple of minutes of the life of this khutbah, inshallah ta'ala. So Ayura has been around for so many years and have been doing some amazing things in over 45 countries in the world. The Philippines, Tanzania, Samoa, Papua New Guinea. They have been to places that I didn't know existed, like what is this Samoa? I didn't know. SubhanAllah, the last year alone, they have given shahadas to about 14,000 people. They supported 12,000 new Muslims. Close to 250,000 publications have been distributed for free. Close to 200 da'wah teams were created throughout the world. Here in Canada, we support imams and du'as and masajid to be able to do da'wah. Da'wah is not the focus for so many masajid. You know, they don't focus. Supporting new Muslims is not a priority for a lot of masajid. And this is why 50 to 60% of all the people who accept Islam, takbir, takbir, 60% they end up leaving the faith because nobody is there to support them. So this is part of our mandate to train imams and du'ats to do da'wah with hikmah, mu'idat al-hasanah properly, systematically, to support new Muslims, to create new teams, to print amazing da'wah materials. As I said, 17 years in the da'wah field, I have never seen anything like this in my life. This was written by the founders and the team they have, mashallah, very logical. This is the best you will find in the market. Amazing, powerful, profound arguments for Islam. Many people who read these, they accept Islam immediately. They don't have to go left or right, and they don't have to confuse people. No, it's very straight to the forward to the point. So these are some of the amazing things that we do. So if you'd like to support us, inshallah, Ayura, you can check out the table outside if you can use the machine or cash, or you can donate online so you can share in this reward. So amazing things are happening, supporting new Muslims, giving shahadas to people. I understand that maybe you don't have the training or the time to help, but the least we can do when we stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on Yawm al-Qiyamah, that is supported financially, inshallah, and you will share the reward with us. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the best in this life and the best in the life to come. Ameen ya Rabbal Alameen. So after Salah, you can check out the table outside and you'll see the brothers and the sisters with red shirts that say Ayura, inshallah. And you can take flyers to learn more about our efforts, or you can join our da'wah team. Jazakallah khair. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the best in this life and the best in the life to come, to give us sincerity in everything we say and do. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give izzah to Islam and Muslims, and to give hidayah to everyone. Ameen ya Rabbal Alameen. Wa afim as-salam.